John Jay to Major League Soccer. Bobby's here with sports. We've got breaking news from the pitch. This is big stuff.
Big time news from a former John Jay boys soccer star. Jake Keegan is going professional. While at John Jay, Keegan notched 79 goals, adding 45 assists. He was an All-State player twice and All-Section three times. In 2008, he led the Patriots to the New York State Final Four while being named the Section 1 Player of the Year.
My name is Jake Keegan, and this is my story.
Keegan running up, headed on, and back to the net. Headed up by Ashley. Good throw by Keegan, and it's in.
So I grew up in the Hudson Valley, New York. I played for John Jay High School, East Fishkill Thunder youth team, legendary youth team back in the day. And as a youth player, I was always good, but I was never the top. I wasn't an All-American in high school, wasn't an All-American in college. So I always kind of had that underdog mentality where I believed I could be better and I could achieve big things, but I wasn't necessarily getting all the recognition at that current time. So it was something that I always had to work for. I always had to work hard, and it's something that I really pride myself on to this day, because I don't think I would be where I am without that, the mentality that I have, the persistence, and also just the work ethic. After high school, I went to Binghamton University, which was, it's a Division I school, but again, it wasn't an ACC school, it wasn't North Carolina, it wasn't Clemson, it wasn't Stanford. And it was another opportunity where I got a chance to prove myself. I wasn't the most highly recruited player out there, but I got a platform to prove myself. And I think the biggest thing in terms of my future professional career was playing in the PDL, which is USL League Two now in the summer. And that was a collection of all the best college players around the country. And I got to play with the Westchester Flames for my first two seasons. So it really gave me that platform to prove myself against the best in the country. And I think it was during that summer, the summer 2011, where I had aspirations to play professionally before that, but it was during that summer that I really had the self-belief that I could go on and I could achieve big things in the game. Out of college, I was drafted by Philadelphia Union in MLS, and I didn't end up signing with the Union. Didn't end up even going on trial with the Union. But I went overseas. I went on trial in Israel. I went on trial in Austria. I eventually went on trial and signed in Germany in the lower leagues. And then from Germany, I had a good half season there, and I signed with a club called Galway United in Ireland. That Irish experience helped me accelerate my professional career, which has now been going on for 8 seasons. Being a pro it's a 365-day-a-year commitment. It's not, oh, I'm going to train hard one day and then I'm going to take 2 days and kind of slack off, because it catches up with you. If you're in college, if you're in high school, you can get away with it more so, especially if you have natural ability. But as a pro, if you eat the wrong thing the day before a game, you're going to feel it, and you're in the 60th minute, you're going to cramp up or you're going to get tired. So it's things that you'll see on this video, I'm sure they're playing right now as we're watching, that I do on a daily basis. It's nothing crazy. It's nothing that an average college player couldn't do once, but it's more about the consistency of doing it. Not every day. You need rest days, of course, but you need to do it consistently over the year and then over however long your career ends up being. The one thing I would tell my younger self is you have to have self-belief. I think there's going to be a lot of days where you fail and you have to get back up and you have to try to fix it the next day. And if you fail the next day, then you've tried to fix it the day after. You can't get too down in the lows of playing, and you also can't get too high, because there's a lot of success and it can get to your head. I mean, you see a lot of top players who fizzle out after a year because they can't consistently do it. So what I would say is just kind of stay consistent, stay persistent, and do all the little things when no one is watching.